So first, he wrote and directed District 9 together with producer Peter Jackson. And then he moved on to Elysium, starring Matt Damon. South African director Neil Blomkamp is at it again with his brand new movie, Chappie, which promises to be a blockbuster.
Into this world.
A machine that can think and feel.
That's it. Come. Come here, little buddy.
That's a watch. That's a watch.
What?
It's like a child, it has to learn.
Your name, Chappie.
Chappie.
Anything you want to do in your life, you can do.
Write poetry, have original ideas.
Wow.
People are always fearful of something they don't understand.
The problem with artificial intelligence is it's way too unpredictable.
You know what's a black sheep?
No.
It's like when you're different to everyone else.
So much more than I could ever have imagined.
We're gonna make you cool and tough.
Don't laugh, I'm being cool.
This robot, he's gonna be removed.
He's just a kid.
He could be the next step in evolution.
I am consciousness. I am alive. I am Chappie.
Welcome to another episode of Top Ceiling, where the ceiling is at the top. I'm your host, Wendy Kumede, and today we're previewing a movie called Chappie. This movie was directed by a South African director, Neil Blomkamp, so you can call us patriotic here at Top Ceiling. This movie is set to come out next year in March, and we're super excited. It's about a robot that basically possesses human emotions and feelings, and I'm quite excited about it. And as you can see, this trailer has about 5 million views now, 5 million views today. I don't know when you're watching this show, so this, consider this a throwback. Okay, so I have a guest in studio to help me discuss this magnificent movie by this director. I hope.
Hello, Wendy.
First of all, you took my job.
What do you mean?
So this is why I'm stuttering on camera.
Yeah, I don't know. You went there. You got sick. So yeah. That's not my fault that you were sick when we did Top
Ceiling. What I'm saying is all these schnit episodes, you can just delete them. I'm back.
Okay, but don't, it's good to be here anyway. So good to have
good
you back.
Have
welcome
you.
Back.
Thank you.
So what were you sick of? You know what? Don't tell us. Let's talk about Chappie. What
is a Chappie? Well, all I can say is it's not contagious, so it's fine.
I'm glad.
You're not gonna get it from watching the show.
Wow.
Awesome. So keep watching the show. Awesome. Okay, so you've just seen the trailer of Chappie. What are your thoughts about this movie?
I must say, you know, I'm a big fan of Neil Blomkamp, but I think when you see this trailer or when you read the tagline, the first thing that comes to mind was, is this again yet another robot movie? Mm-hmm. But I think the more I watched it, I'm like, wait, I think there's something different about this one. So that was my first thought. Big fan of Neil Blomkamp, so I definitely will be seeing it. In fact, it releases on my birthday, 6 March. So please send in birthday presents or comments in the section below. But anyway.
Yeah. I love how he just threw that in there. I love how you just
did
that. So tactful. Yeah. But yeah, I must agree with you. Neil is one of those directors that has been very consistent with the way that he approaches film. So in as much as you may think that it's another robot film or another sci-fi from Neil, I think he possesses sort of a stamp.
Okay.
So to speak, he has a personality that comes out in his films. He's very consistent in his theme, and that's why he's produced something like this. In my opinion, I think that's what he's been doing.
But how do you feel about this movie? Is this something you're gonna watch, or what stands out for you?
This is definitely something I'm gonna watch. I saw an explosion somewhere in the trailer, and I already decided that I'm getting myself a ticket.
Look, I'll say this. That's one thing. One of the things that I like about Neil Blomkamp's movies is that he comes from a visual effects background.
Mm-hmm.
And so, which means he's quite hands-on involved. And like when I watched Elysium and I watched the behind the scenes, I saw that he was involved with everything in the visual effects.
Yeah.
And that's something I think that why his movies feel, although they're sci-fi films, they're quite grounded.
Mm-hmm.
And so one of the things I am looking forward to is just explosive, but that grungy, realistic feeling to his visual effects. So I'm excited about that.
I'm excited too, I must say.
Yeah. And okay, tell us about the actors. Who are in this?
Well, an appearance that I saw in the trailer, the main appearance was Dev Patel, and he was...
Not Hugh Jackman.
Well, he wasn't really the main person in the trailer. I think he made a few appearances towards the end.
Mm.
But you can tell that the main person, apart from Chappie, in this movie is Dev Patel, whatever character that he is in the film. And we know him from Slumdog Millionaire.
Yeah.
Slumdog Millionaire is an award-winning film. So by virtue of having the main character from there in your movie, Neil, I think it was a very good move. And of course, Hugh Jackman is in there. Hugh Jackman, Wolverine. He's known for his method acting. He's an A-list actor from Hollywood, so I'm looking forward to that as well. I mean, I'm super stoked to see those people in there.
I mean, this probably goes without saying, it's a Neil Blomkamp movie, so you know Charlton Copley is there.
Oh yeah.
But for me, this is a good thing. I think just seeing, obviously in District 9, Charlton was there as well with his famous Vikas van der Merwe. Awe, Vikas.
Van der Merwe.
And then he made it also to Elysium, doing well for himself, and I think it's comfortable to say that from District 9, Charlton Copley landed his role on the A-Team playing Murdoch, which was, again, excellent. And so I think I'm interested to see now Charlton Copley is going to be playing Chappie, going to obviously be doing the motion capture and the voice for Chappie. So I'm looking forward to just seeing him doing that. Also features Sigourney Weaver. Now, Sigourney Weaver, obviously, I think last I saw her was on Avatar.
Yeah.
And so it's interesting. I think sometimes I always think of Sigourney Weaver as someone who does that, I don't know, nature, always caring about nature.
Like preserving, nurture.
You know what I mean? So I'm wondering what kind of element she brings into this film. But I think it talks, again, one of the things that I like about Neil Blomkamp's movies is that there's always a massive South African stamp.
Yes.
That a lot of South African actors, this film has a lot of South African actors that are featuring this. So again, Neil Blomkamp, thumbs up. We are here.
This is an audition for you.
But
basically,
yeah, this is us auditioning. So yeah. Anyway, in terms of again the South African flavor, I mean, anything else you can say about that?
Another smart thing that he did, I don't know if you guys noticed this in the trailer, is that Chappie had a stamp, like a South African stamp of the South African flag, basically on his shoulder, and that's sort of, I mean, if that doesn't say patriotic, I don't know what. So a good move for Neil as well.
Because even on the inside, it doesn't say made in China. It actually says made in South Africa.
Does it say made in South Africa?
I don't know. I just made it up.
Well, the movie was made in South Africa. I saw Joburg, and I appreciated that.
Yeah.
I appreciated seeing familiar streets,
Yeah,
so that's good.
Yeah, and I think it's like, you kind of have to get your mind around it, seeing Metro Rail in a movie, and then you're like, whoa. Hey, is that Sipo there in the train? You know what I mean? Fantastic.
And I think I saw myself pass with like a pick and pay plastic bag. No, I didn't. You know what, though?
Yeah.
This is what I appreciate about Neil, because South Africa has become a landmark for film.
Yeah.
You have international directors coming in to make their movies, and then they leave the country.
Yes.
So I love the fact that Neil took advantage of his own country and he used South African cities to tell his story. I really appreciate that. It's a twist. Looking at the trailer, you can see that there's an actual character development.
Mm.
We see the character at a very vulnerable stage, and then at the end of it, he's finding himself. So it's a story that humans will be able to relate to as well.
Yeah.
I think it has very little to do with the fact that Chappie is a robot, actually.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm just drawing this from the trailer. So this is a movie that you guys have to watch. Girls, go there with tissues, and guys, try to stay strong. It challenges identity from a different perspective.
Yeah.
We've seen identity being challenged in South African film in various ways.
Yeah.
You know, we have movies about HIV and AIDS. We have movies about orphans trying to find themselves in big cities. But this is different. This is something really different. And he challenges us. He challenges us in this film.
Wendy, is this an Oscar nomination candidate?
Well, I think it qualifies to be an Oscar nomination candidate, because although it has these major effects, visual effects, and you can see that the production was very intensive, it's also a very heartwarming story. It has depth, it has heart, and I think that I would like to see Neil get some credit for this movie. Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, so thank you for coming to the show, coming to the other side, stepping away from the camera.
You don't look happy that I'm here.
I mean, it's been a rough couple of episodes.
Oof, okay.
Well, that's it for today. I'm your actual host, Wendy Kumede, and you've been watching Top Ceiling, where the ceiling is at the top. another person that we have there is Dave Patel. Dave.
Oh, David.
Why is his name Dave?
Wendy, tell us, in terms of the actors, who do...
I'm fixing, I'm so sorry.
Are you done fixing? Like, we could fix you out there.
No, you're right.
Okay.
Is it an Oscar nomination, Neil? We'll have to find out.
And close the show.